The first step to add or subtract radicals is to simplify the radicals, then identify the like radicals, and then add or subtract the like radicals by adding or subtracting the coefficients. So for 8 square root 3 minus 2 square root 27, we first want to simplify the square roots. Well, square root 3 does not simplify because it does not contain any perfect square factors, but square root 27 does because it contains a factor of 9. Now, if we have a hard time identifying perfect square factors, we can always write out the prime factorization for 27. Let's go ahead and do that. 27 is equal to 3 times 9, where 3 is prime, and 9 is equal to 3 times 3. So we can rewrite 27 as a product of 3 3's. So we'd have 8 square root 3 minus 2 times 3 times 3 times 3. Every time we have two equal factors, we have a perfect square factor. So 3 times 3, or 9, is a perfect square factor of 27. So this simplifies. So we'd have 8 square root 3 minus 2 times, well, the square root of 3 times 3, or the square root of 3 squared, is equal to 3. And then we still have this 3 underneath the square root. So this simplifies to 8 square root 3 minus 6 square root 3. Notice how both terms contain a factor of square root 3. So the indexes are both 2, and the radicands are both 3. So these are like radicals. So we can subtract them by subtracting the coefficients. And since 8 minus 6 is equal to 2, 8 square root 3 minus 6 square root 3 is equal to 2 square root 3. Next we have 2 square root 8 plus 3 square root 22. So we need to start by simplifying the square roots. And to help us identify the perfect square factors, we'll go ahead and write out the prime factorization of 8, which would be 2 times 2 times 2 plus 3 times the square root of the prime factorization of 32. Let's go ahead and make a prime factorization tree for 32. It's 4 times 8. 4 is equal to 2 times 2. 8 is equal to 4 times 2, and 4 is equal to 2 times 2. So we have 5 factors of 2. Again, if we know our perfect square factors, that can save us some time, but this method always works. And now we'll circle the perfect square factors. Here's 2 factors of 2, 2 factors of 2 here, and 2 factors of 2 here. And the square root of 2 times 2, or the square root of 2 squared, is 2. So here we'd have 2 times another factor of 2, square root 2, plus 3 times, this would simplify to a factor of 2, and so would this. So we have 2 times 2 times square root 2. So this would be 4 square root 2, plus 3 times 2 times 2 is 12 square roots of 2. And now they both contain a factor of square root 2. So the indexes are the same because they're both square roots. The radicands are both 2, so these are like radicals. So now we can combine them by adding the coefficients. Since 4 plus 12 is equal to 16, 4 square root 2 plus 12 square root 2 is equal to 16 square roots of 2. I hope you found this helpful.